Welcome everyone, it's Vapors of Dracomar. It's time for some more Great Shadow Legends. Dungeons. Oh joy. Guess who we can try to ascend again? Cythia Flame Tongue. Yep. Let's try it again. Let's try to get our last ascension potion. Reinformation, getting our last ascension potion is a very unpleasant endeavor. I could just go to full tryhard team comp, but I'd like to include Ninja and some of it. Because I've got to use 50 energy, and then I gotta go fight my least favorite mode in the game. Oh, and before you ask, I do have to work really hard to go through arena and to get this ascension potion, because this boss loves to troll. Make it very hard to get these potions. Funny about this boss is, no matter how much you land on, the girl cares. There also comes a time where this boss is so defensive. You have to resort to a very defensive comp yourself, or else get destroyed by his BS. But yes, I'm gonna be climbing up these looking for the potion. Not gonna go straight for the most troll annoying boss yet. I'm just gonna go climbing. And in the process of climbing, I might find it. You never know. Because there's a lot of RNG when it comes to this, to actually getting these potions. More than you think, even at the highest levels. Stares into your soul, those steaming red, merciless eyes, and this armor of doom. The mace of doom. It's dipped in magma, forged in the deepest, darkest depths. And all he does with it is swing. Did it. Fight in classic arena, boys. where I fight a very similar team comp to me. I don't want to get promoted, because getting promoted means I have to experience BS. BNS. I don't need BS. I don't need it. There we go. That's an easy one. I'll take any easy battles. I'll take them. No, I don't want to get promoted. Shit. Okay, I'll fight him anyway. Give me that. Even if he gets one shot, I'll back him. I've got backup. That is a really expensive shop. Let's give it a shot. Right, somehow that completely owns me. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Calvifen is well built. I didn't want to stay in that rank anyway. It was Screw being high rank. Screw that. I don't want to be in a good rank. I want to lose. Because winning means you get people that are too high. Kind of like this Nutball, who somehow has a heavy and a creeping Whirlim. Where the frick you got that from? Good God. I have to remember that I do have two support. I do have that. Got him. Not again. I got promoted again. All right. Where? Let's try this. I will continue to forgot to do this even. Which is a shame, but yeah. Elf and Dwarf. I could do that on my other account, I suppose. Let's open 10 shards and see what happens. Load of food. I mean, yeah, Sister Militant's useful, but... didn't do any ice golem though. let's do some ice golem. I probably can do the higher level now, though, come to think of it, because I have a better team. I'm gonna try it with Sophia and my new tender. Because I haven't actually done any ice golem. I think I can move higher now. Because Relic Retender prevents bad debuffs from appearing on the team. All these debuffs can be easily cleansed now. Assuming she can. Protect up. Going. Well, I can decrease its damage, which is not bad. Got him. We haven't done any Minotaur. What's the highest Minotaur have I done? Let's go deeper. I don't think I've gone this deep. Cause yeah, we haven't plumbed the depths of this Minotaur yet. I might include Relic Retender though for this one. Cause that could give us an imagine what this team could do with masteries. Neat. Could be something to think about. Hmm. Because if this gets really rough, I can put in a little Reliquary Tender in here. The Reliquary Tender will be able to save the game. It doesn't matter how much... Well, almost doesn't matter. But she can pick up people from everything block revive. To my knowledge, this guy does not do block revive. So he's not that much of a jerk, so... That means... Yeah, we can plumb the depths of this easily with that. I'm a bit afraid of the depths of this, so I'm just gonna shove in the Reliquary Tender. I'm a bit afraid. That's why I decided to. As a rule of thumb, when things get scary, bring out your supports. Especially your Rezzers and your Cleansers. Get a burn on here. Yeah, burn. Burn. Burn it all. Burn it. Keep him burning. Might provoke. Can provoke. Heal. Try to keep her alive. Get spicier on the way down. Heals and revives start to become more powerful. Well, it's actually going better than expected. Which I'm happy about. Also, I was concerned that we couldn't get to the bottom of Minotaur's lair. Thankfully, that is no longer a concern. I think we can comfortably get down there. Let's see if we can beat Minotaur, the bottom of Minotaur. That's the real test. Can we beat the bottom? Yes, let's go to the bottom of the Minotaur. Nice. Cause yeah, we haven't done that on this account. Yes, sorry, we have not done that yet. All I know is even if he puts the hex on me, I can cleanse the hex. One thing I like about this team comp. If you get too much debuff on you, you can just cleanse it. Awesome. They can't do double damage. If the hex debuff isn't on, you can't do double damage. One thing I like about Reliquary, he removes a lot of the Minotaur's power with that. A lot of Minotaur's power relies on those hexes. Turn left. Boom. Now, this is the final Minotaur, the scariest Minotaur of all. Now the reason that I want all these masteries, by the way, the favors me, why do you want these masteries? Very simple. Masteries grant me a lot of power. Imagine one of these champions with Warmaster procs. Just envision it, or defense, amazing defense, selfless defender. Imagine Taragi with that. That would prevent a lot of unneeded deaths, which would be great in Arena. Because a lot of the time, I need someone to take a hit for Kale. So that's why I'm thinking Selfless Defender would be good. So that at least Taragi could soak up Kale's DPS power. So that I can soak up the damage intended for Kale, so that he can stay alive longer. And like advanced content, like Arena and stuff. Arena is the biggest one, because Arena, everyone's overpowered in Arena. So that's part of why I'm concerned about Arena more than anything. So I'm not like in a major Arena buff, but I need to do a fair amount of it for my clan. So it would be best if I had like a way to yeah, this is Minotaur 15. These hexes off, because I do not want to know what these cleanses do at this level. Because having these hexes go off on my teammates is gonna blow them up, because they're not as strong defensively as, let's say, Fergus's or another account with the more advanced defensive gear. So I would rather not figure out how much that hex does, because it would probably destroy some of these people. They're not as durable. Like, they've got more defensive options in terms of shields, heals, cleanses, and revives, but they don't have as much raw durability. The raw durability isn't there, so I have to flex my options in other defensive ways, like defensive tools instead of defensive stats. I mean, they have okay defensive stats, but it's not compared to their actual ability. Defensive stats versus defensive abilities. In terms of actual defensive abilities, here's the thing. If they both this place, this account, and the other account had equal stats, this account would be better. Something like that. I don't know, like, Virgus is his own strength. And it's just really strong durability. And he has okay debuffs. I'm gonna get that speed boosted. There are so many champs in this game. But yeah, this is not a bad Minotaur 15, I must say. Like, I was not expecting this level of Minotaur to go this slow. I was expecting this to be a lot worse than this. Yep.